Hi, welcome to the Online Jewelry Academy. I'm Professor John Ahr, and I'm your instructor. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to make a basic chain. But first, let me tell you that even high-end jewelry stores use machine-made chain. It's virtually impossible for you to effectively manipulate little tiny wires and solder them correctly. So I'm giving you permission right now to go ahead and buy your chain and put your pendants and other objects that you make onto a machine manufactured chain. But if you're the kind of jeweler who takes pride in the fact that you make every single part of your pieces, then you're gonna have to know how to make a chain. And that's what I'm going to show you in this video. But before I do, now would be a great time to subscribe to this channel and to hit the notification bell so that you're notified of all new releases. All chains are made from jump rings. I'll be using round jump rings that I've made with my Durston ringer. The Durston ringer is great for quickly making a lot of consistently sized jump rings. This is helpful in both a manufacturing and an educational environment. For those of you who haven't yet reached the point where you would own a tool like this, I have a video on making jump rings using dowels and other basic jewelry making tools. You can find that on our playlist on onlinejewelryacademy.com. Don't forget that during this entire process, you'll need to practice safety precautions and wear your safety glasses. First, you want to carefully secure Durston's keyless chuck into your vise. Now, mount the coil holder into the keyless chuck. With the wire pushed through the hole in the coil holder, you slowly rotate the handle while keeping tension on the wire until you coil the wire almost to the end of the coil holder. If you aren't going to need a lot of jump rings, just make the coil long enough to make as many jump rings as you're going to need. Keep the tension on the wire even as you wind the coil, and don't try to wind till you reach the end of your wire. You could cut yourself when the tension in the coil is released. Once you've removed the coil from the coiling tool, trim the ends, and you lined up the cutting tool on your flex shaft like I demonstrated in the Durston ringer demonstration video. Then, put the coil in the coil holder, making sure the end of the coil is against the stop. You can now rub a light coating of lubricant that came with the ringer onto the coil. Put the top on and hand tighten the two screws. Now, with the coil holder securely mounted in your vise and the Durston cutting blade mounted in your flex shaft, you slowly cut the coil. And voila, you now have a pile of perfectly cut and uniformly sized jump rings. Now that we have the jump rings, let's do something with them. On my charcoal block, I laid out 1 millimeter solder pallions and then placed the fluxed closed seam of a jump ring on each piece of solder. I did this by first holding each jump ring with a pair of pliers on each side. Then I push the ends together as I worked the jump rings closed. I take my flux brush and put some flux on the seam and then place the seam on top of the solder. I heat up each piece using the torch. The flame needs to be kept moving in a circular motion until the piece gets hot enough that the solder melts and is pulled into the seam. Now I just pick them all up with my solder pick and quench them. Next, you make groups of three jump rings by connecting two unsoldered links to one that you've already soldered. To solder the open links, we'll be using a different soldering technique called pick soldering. Hang your group of three jump rings by one of the unsoldered jump rings at the very tip of a third hand and apply flux to the seam. You can sprinkle some solder pallions onto your charcoal block and heat one up until it melts into a ball. Immediately poke it with your cold solder pick and pick it up. Use your torch to heat up the jump ring. When the jump ring gets hot enough, just touch the solder on your soldering pick to the seam. The solder will melt and immediately be drawn into the seam. Now don't forget to quench it. Then turn it over and solder the last unsoldered jump ring in that group. When you're done, you'll have used about 2/3 of your jump rings, and you should have a bunch of unpickled groups with 3 soldered jump rings. Next, you're going to solder a link that will connect the 2 groups of 3 to make them into a group of 7. You continue like this until you have a chain link that you want. I've made a relatively small chain for this demonstration. It sure looks dirty, doesn't it? If you're going to transform this into a curb chain, you don't need to clean it yet. Just put one end of the chain into a vise and using your solder pick, pull on the chain, keeping a firm tension while you turn it slowly to the right. Because the soldering process also annealed the links, it's fairly easy to turn. The links almost seem like they're reorganizing as I make each turn. Then finally, they all just line up and I have a flat curb chain. Isn't that neat? Of course, you now need to clean the chain by pickling and brass brushing it. If you want to turn your basic chain into a drawn chain, you can pull it through a draw plate, but you would absolutely want to pickle and brass brush the chain to be sure that it's perfectly clean before running it through your precision equipment. I'm going to draw my chain using my Durston tabletop draw bench. I love this tool because it makes drawing chain and wire a breeze. Plus, it's wonderful for home studios because it can easily be stored when you're not using it. First, I put some lubricant on the chain. Then, I thread a loop of wire through the end of the chain and thread the ends of the wire through the draw plate. I then grab the ends of the wire with the Durston draw tongs. Put the triangular metal piece over the draw tongs and slowly draw the chain through. It takes several passes through the draw plate to get a good looking drawn chain. The holes in the draw plate become sequentially smaller and you must draw the chain down one hole at a time until you achieve the desired profile. I also want to mention that just like the Durston ringer, if you're not at the point where owning this level of equipment is justified, you can pull the chain by hand. You do it in almost the same manner as I've shown in some of my twisted wire videos. I hope you like this video. We have over 350 free videos on our YouTube channel that you can also find on our website at onlinejewelryacademy.com. We also have 3 paid courses on udemy.com. We have one on setting stones in 5 different types of settings, one on making a hinged bracelet, and one which does have a section on pulling chain by hand called Colorful Silver Jewelry. There are discount codes in the description to this video. If you're interested in learning more about Durston Tools, you can visit their website at durston.com/OJA or click on the links in the description below. Purchases made using those links will help to support the Online Jewelry Academy and don't raise the price of the tools 1 cent. Thanks for watching.